In this video, we will show you how to use the geological cross sections for 3D subsoil modeling. We will open the geological sections which we created in the previous video and add interfaces to the lines. We will add the fill material interface. Next, we will create the interface of bedrock and interfaces of other geotechnical types. We can't input the lens directly, so we will model the top of the lens and bottom of the lens. Now we have all interfaces in the first cross section set. It is necessary to repeat this process for all cross sections we intend to use for the geological model. However, here, we only select the interfaces from the list. Next, we open up the frame Interfaces, where we see the points, which were created from the geological cross sections. Next, we will proceed to the generation of the model. First, you need to select the master borehole. The master borehole should have the largest number of layers. We will assign the interfaces into the table of layers. We also need to change the order of generation for some continuous interfaces. If the order wasn't changed, the layers would be generated from top to bottom. By changing the order, we make sure the model gets generated correctly. Now, we generate the model. After the geological model is generated, we will compare it with the original geological cross sections. We can easily see that the clay layer was created in this area, where it is not present in the first geological section. This is typical when modeling lenses. The interface of the lens is defined only in a small area. The program does calculate the rest of the interface automatically, although not always correctly. The solution is to add a new point of the interface above the terrain. Hence, we open the relevant geological section where we add an auxiliary line above the terrain and assign it to the interface, GT6 clays. Now, we will generate the model again. The clay layer is now correct. When comparing with the geological section, we can see that the layer of loess silt still isn't generated. This is because it is not present in the master borehole. From the original cross sections, we can see that this layer is right below the fill material interface. Hence, we add it into the master borehole right below this interface. The location in the borehole will then be above the terrain. We add the interface into the table of layers and generate the model again. The geological model now fully corresponds with the input geological cross sections. The geological model can be easily edited with new boreholes. We add and edit new boreholes until we are fully satisfied with the result. For more information, subscribe to our video channel or visit our website.